One from Clayster, but let's kick things off with the attacking team. Nature has the bomber. Was that Scumpy with a sniper rifle? Ooh, I'm
why?
I want to see some crazy stuff. He's just going to be watching the flank, though, and already Killer puts the first kill there on Clayster. Very, very early first blood into this round. Bomb carry Nature is going to have an engagement any second. Now he's caught reloading, though, and Killer's going to get his second kill. And Proofy's pre-aiming where Killer is, and unfortunately Ambos has just needed Scump, so up to gaming, not to the best start.
Well, Killer, the best S&D player in the world, starts stuff off hot. Proofy finally able to get OG on the board here. You see via the Oracle mode, he has one on his flank.
Another player just get out.
Kind of mid.
No, don't turn on that. Proofy learned to behave.
Yeah, turning on the white truck head glitch from that range and that angle is it's difficult.
Yes. If he'd have killed Miracles, you see Miracles all smiles there.
The vector is.
The vector long range.
Oh my god.
Yeah, Miracles very talented at controlling that. And obviously Nation, of course, take that first round. And anyone from Nation you want to spectate off the bat?
Miracles. You know, he's been the guy we've kind of been talking about yesterday. Okay. Really shut up, and this weekend's been playing just amazing. So let's see what he can get done here. Looks like he is going to be the player that's going to be pushing into post, and also your bomb carrier here for this one.
Designated bomb carrier, as you said. Is he going to go for the rush plant? He threw that smoke early, but he's going to go for the challenge with the bomb. Kind of crazy play. He's going to get the kill, though, on, I believe that was Clayster. But Scumpy managed to get a two-piece amidst all that. So, Miracle's challenging with the bomb has left it in a horrible position. It's never really recommended that you get so overzealous with the bomb, but Ricky's now left in a 1v3. Not the best of positions either, Maven.
Well, they played the defense really aggressive. You know, you saw Killer got those kills so quickly up mid-street. It looked like they wanted to play the offense very aggressive as well. Clear that out at Water Tower as quickly as they could in 10, and then I guess revert back and try to get the plant. But like you said, if that fails, leaving the bomb up there, you're not getting that back, especially when it's a 1v3. But let's see what Ricky can do. He's got 30 seconds to work with. I mean, honestly, here, we talk about how offense is the favorite side. If this comes down to a round 11, you want to be the favorite side. If you're Ricky with this much time, do you even try to pick up kills right now?
I mean, it's a tough one because at the same time, as you said, you know, if it gets to round 11, the team with the most kills will get the defensive side, so you have to kind of think about that as well.
I don't think he didn't really have enough time to get three in the bomb down.
He was never going to win that round.
He didn't seem to really be trying to push that out really that hard and pick up kills, and that's what you'll see sometimes on this map. But that will bring it to 1-1 here. There's Ricky. Never one to show a whole lot of emotion.
Yeah, he's can be relatively emotional at times, but... You know, the player I really want to watch this round at least is going to be this man, Scumpy. He's going to be sort of watching the fight. We've seen him a little bit more aggressive than he did last round. He has that SMGI. He's going to be watching the middle of the map. He's 2-1. Nade goes flying in. He's going to have to immediately back up, but his teammates are going to be challenging. And Embos wins that gunfight. So nicely played by Embos. Optic Nation with a good nade communication coming out.
And Scump's got to get going. You know, Nashville, he was really well in S&D. It's one of the best times I've seen him play. He had one or two aces, I think, on the weekend. But so far here, he hasn't really gotten it going in S&D. You know, you saw the 0-8 the first night and just not really putting up big numbers. They need him to get going.
I love this play from Optic Gaming, by the way.
Yeah, so do I.
This is basically Nature saying, all right, Killer, I know how you like to play S&D. Guess what? Anything you can do, we can do as well. And he managed to push that B site, and you see Opti Nation just so convinced. But this is a really heads-up play from this player from Opti Nation. It's actually Ricky. Ricky anticipating the rotation back, and now Opti Nation going to have to spin all the way around. But Nature's going to need to have to get this bomb down
play
as quickly as possible.
Huge.
But Clayster with a massive two-piece there. That's going to allow Nature to get that bomb down. But as I said, love that play from Nature using killer strategies against him, and that leaves now Miracles in a 1v3.
Yeah, just smart stuff by Clay. And Miracles should be able to get one. He's going to have a 1v2 now. Nade and Clay left last alive. And we'll see here if how he's going to push this out. Looks like he's going to come from the back. He'll lose that immediately. Clay with three. He didn't have. Yeah, he had three big kills there. I loved it. He pushed out. He got that player that was waiting, which was Ricky. And immediately, he's like, where else are they going to be coming from? Zig is the next spot. He checked it immediately. Picked up that second kill. Really set the tone for me.
Now, Optic Nation going to be on the attacking side. Miracle's having a really good game so far. 3-2. You got Ricky and Nature, both players in the game still. Yet to find their first kill. So keep your eyes out on them. And are Optic Nation going to change anything up? Doesn't look like it. Seems like they're content on this B play. But again, heads up play from Optic Gaming in that last round to kind of just think outside the box a little bit there.
Yeah, I thought it was going to fall apart to a bit when Ricky kind of sniffed it out. But they, the big kills I play got it done. So let's see how this one works out. Nades coming out from kill. That's going to be the smoke.
He's
going to go for a quick play. He's getting the headshot from play. Was that a snipe that came in? Kill a first down advantage to Optic Gaming. 60 seconds left here in this round. We'll see who picks up the next kill.
What? Miracle's just
sniffing that one out.
Right? There's some Interesting wall hacks going on there. Miracle is just randomly firing. Unfortunately, didn't get the kill, but he got the hit markers, and now he's going to be forced to play a little bit aggressive. There's one. Can he find the second? No, he can't. Nadeshot shuts him down. Embos goes down as well. Ricky in a 1v3 once again on the attacking side. This time, though, can he try and manage it? He has 38 seconds left. Bomb down in a much more favorable position than it was last time.
We've seen this before, haven't we?
Right. Deja vu. Yeah.
We'll see. You know, again, we're going to talk about it. Is he going to try to get kills here or just kind of play it slow? We'll see if he's...
Oh, as soon as he stopped ADSing, Scump peeks around the corner and pops him. Nice play. But Proofy, once again, off to a fantastic start in this Search and Destroy. 5-2 advantage for him.
I love that stuff. A nice shot there by Scump. Always great to see him sniping Rick. Always stoic. See the face there. 3-1 advantage right now for Optic Gaming. We talked about it before this series. We talked about it during the series. This is one the nation has to win. And right now, not exactly getting it done. But let's see. We'll hop on board Proofy. He's the hot hand. He's 5-2. See if he can get a first blood.
I love how Nature and Scump have basically just really, really delayed everything. The smoke grenades are going to come out. Krim's going to be absolutely loving that, I'm sure. And Proofy's going to throw the nade over and immediately back off. And such smart play coming in from Gaming, really using some T1 S&D strats right there, delaying the push, really taking the time. This A site is wide open. You still have Proofy as well, watching to see if anyone is going to rotate from B. He needs to be careful though, because there is a play behind him. You can see Proofy highlighted in yellow on that mini map as well. Scumpy is going to be watching Zig. There's going to be a player there. Nicely played. Now Proofy could potentially have a kill player up top. This should come in. Oh, he's not going to get it though. One more player coming out of post. Bomb has gone down. Meanwhile, Proof should clean him up. No! He's panic knifing.
Get him out! How is he still alive?
Oh, my lord.
Finally going to drop. 30 seconds left of the clock. We're into 3v3. Bomb is down. 4 Optic Gaming. You see Scump with the snipe. He's watching the backside, but both players. There's going to be two coming from Zig, I think. Who's the player in American watching it? That's going to be Nade shot. He's got one. Can he get a second? He's going to get two. Great stuff from Nade. One player left. That's Ricky coming around. Ricky loves 1v3s, apparently.
Yeah, he's always left in 1v3, and you have to feel sorry because right now he is 0-4. But he's been left in a 1v3
three rounds. He shouldn't kill anyone, technically.
Right. it's kind of like, well, feel bad for the guy right there. But Optic Gaming, nice little strategy there, delaying the push. Yeah. Proofy baiting out B, and then Optic Gaming just saying, hey, we've got a free bomb site.
Well,
right
it kind of backfired because they had a great nade from Nation on that white truck. You know, it's a famous spot. But he got a hit marker. Proofy took damage, so they think, oh, they're coming B like normal. Tricks on them. Three players from Optic Gaming go away.
Miracles with the bomb being aggressive, watching the fight here. He needs to pick up this kill. Can't afford to die, and Nadeshot gets the kill, and that is going to be Nadeshot calling out. That's Bomb, and immediately Optic Gaming saying, all right, thank you very much. We now know where Bomb is. We can just divert all of our efforts into just covering that, and Nation not in the best of spots, and we said this is a must-win for Optic Nation. They're 4-1 down here in Search and Destroy Warhawk as Nadeshot picks up another kill as Embos goes to try and pick up that bomb. Now it's Killer and Ricky, 2v4. Maven, this is not looking good at
all. Well, where that bomb is, it's in a tiny little, basically a little
alleyway.
Yeah, it's just sitting there with Nadeshot staring at it with a sub. It's going to be so tough to get. We'll see if Killa can win this gunfight. Hit markers, but no can do. Two left alive, 40 seconds left on the clock. This is a very, very tough spot once again for Nation.
Yep, time dwindling away. Killa's going to see one. Not going to be able to hit those shots, but hit markers again for Killa. I mean, he looks towards Gate. He's going to need some help from Ricky. Ricky being very, very passive right now. And with 23 seconds left in a 2v4, you can't really afford to... Oh, sorry, 2v3, you can't really afford to be that passive. Now Killer's going to try and make a play for the farm. He's going to manage to run across, but, you know, Nadeshot's just sitting there on the left side.
Nadeshot's been in a 10-foot radius of that bomb for the last minute.
Yep, this is actually Nadeshot for the potential ace. He's going to turn around the corner, and he is going to pick it up, surely. There it is, Nadeshot picking up an ace.
Impressive stuff.
And forcing 5-1. That's a 7-1. Optic Nadeshot, a fantastic round for him. And as soon as he got that first kill on Miracles, who had the bomb, first of all, you have to question, why is the bomb carrier lying there?
Yeah.
I mean, that's just never a smart place to leave your bomb carrier, especially unsupported.
Yeah.
That's just, you can't afford to do that.
It's a weekend of revenge. You know, Noble got the revenge on Denial. Optic got the revenge on Ryze. Now they want the revenge on Nation. You know, nothing has gone right. Bracket-wise, and right now we're seeing Optic Gaming at their finest. 5-1 advantage. Do you think this is the one they close it out on, Benson?
With the way Nadeshot's playing right now, 7-point spree, 7 kills, 1 death, and 2 plants. Scumpy getting first blood with the sniper rifle. He's 6-2 as well. Talk about turning things around in Search and Destroy Warhawk. 0-8 yesterday in S&D, and now 6-2. However, Ricky managed to get a kill. Can Nadeshot find his 8th of the game. There's going to be a player in post, turns around, and gets the kill on Killer. And Ricky, once again, in a one.
Is this a joke?
Two.
Poor Ricky.
I feel bad for the guy. He has four kills now, though. Can Nadeshot seal the deal? Ricky comes in from behind, picks up one. Can he find the second? I think he actually knows where Proofy is, but Proofy in the one versus one. Ricky's going to see him, gets the shots on, not able to pick up the kill. He has no idea where Proofy's going. Free firing! And Proofy's just running away! It's ringing around the road! He gets the knife, though! Fantastic stuff from Ricky.
Oh my god.
You see, he's maybe a sigh of relief there. He's going, guys, I was just trying to chase Proofy. Yeah. Just kept running away.
The game of hot potato. Just couldn't track him down. Finally gets it. Ricky, he's had, what, this fourth opportunity to possibly clutch it. This one, obviously, a little more realistic, and he gets it done.
Right, yeah, exactly that. He got a very early kill on Nadeshot immediately after he planted that bomb. And from then, Proofy kind of gave away his position a little bit, but he still had to try and find him. And that chase took a little bit longer than I'm sure Ricky felt comfortable with.
That was a delight to watch.
Yeah, Ricky actually on a 5-point spree as well, so I'm going to kick things off on board with him. Miracle's obviously the bomb carry this time. He's not going to do anything overzealous, pushing towards that A site. Just a traditional kind of wait out B, see if Ricky can try to get a pick. Needs to be careful, they're behind this white van. Nades could come flying in. The smoke grenade goes down. Miracle's waiting for the okay to try and get that plan, but Optic Gaming actually going for a mid-street.
As Krim said, the four smokes coming in. Yep. They get him down. Ricky
Nade
there.
Shot
oh,
three
Nade.
Piece. Oh my lord.
Three-piece with Skump being a part of it, though.
Oh, yeah. Touche. Touche. But hey, a three-piece nevertheless.
2v2 here. 50 seconds left on the clock. Nade and Proof versus Ricky and Miracles. Who you got in this one?
To be honest, it's a tough call. If Miracles can get this kill, he just can't die with the bomb. Here he turns. He's gonna have Nadeshot.
Oh
my
what?
God, no, do not get turned on by Nadeshot. That would be awkward.
Oh,
Proofy
no.
And Nadeshot come in. Nadeshot gets the kill. It isn't that nasty of a turn on, because you have to bear in mind, of course, at that point Miracles was trying to kill Proofy, but Nadeshot just jumps around the corner.
Miracles thought he had
him
dead.
One shot.
He thought he killed